So the sand is atrocious. All right. Moto was like, he feels good about himself. He won a game. Let's make him go to some awful number. Some awful piddly number. He's also mulliganing, though, so we're probably fine. The fact that it's such a good matchup, too. He's mulling for Stony Silence. We're mulling for a land. Yeah, he's down to five. Okay, this hand's okay. I think this is the one Mind Stone left in the deck. Not playing Mind Stone because we wouldn't do anything with the mana next turn anyway, and we wouldn't be able to hold up Erase if we played it. So he'll crack the Arid Mesa. And probably shift the turn back. We'll untap, play Seat, use the blue sources to play Mind Stone. Snapcaster. We've got those 2-mana 2/1 beats going on. Rawr. Definitely more acceptable in this matchup than usual, that's for sure. Now I'm not even gonna cast the Mind Stone, I'm gonna cast Thirst on his end of turn, so. Then if he remands it on his end of turn, we can untap and go Mind Stone Thirst. Two one, too strong. That Ambush Viper, though. I plan on going the Mind Stone into Ichor Wellspring, keeping white open, but let me draw another Thirst, so we're going to do that. This is going very well. We haven't been clicked or anything mean. He has four cards in hand, no clue what they could be. King Thirst. We actually don't have a second white for Open the Vaults. I might crack the Mind Stone to draw a card, but I think having the mana is going to be important. We are short on white sources. Senses Rev. I'm just gonna remand that. I need to cantrip deeper into my deck. At least we found enough white mana. He's probably gonna rev for three here. Do we play the extra prism? I don't think we do. Although, Yeah, actually, yeah, we do. Because if he goes Stony Silence and we go erase his end of turn, we can untap and just cast the erase because we found a Glimmer Void. Yeah, playing Prism's fine. It's a good thing he didn't have any real pressure, like a Resto on four to complement that Snapcaster. We'd be right around dead life. Even if he just goes like he's got four cards in hand, if he goes Bolt plus Snapcaster here, we're under a lot of pressure to combo. With not much to do it with. What's our graveyard like? Mind Stone and One Acre Wellspring that we discarded to a Thirst earlier. Yeah, there's the Rev for three, that's fine. But we can sacrifice another Mind Stone to have another draw. It's really an awkward draw card, though. It's mostly there just to accelerate out the KCI on turn three, and then it's not like a brick when you're comboing. But it's obviously not an ideal combo card. Relic, okay. Relic's usually a pretty easy card to play around. Which hopefully I can show you now if this KCI resolves. I think we have Emrakul mana if this KCI resolves. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Yeah, normally I would have that 2-mana spell that makes things cost three the 2-mana artifact that makes things cost 3 extra mana if you cast it on your opponent's turn. But the problem is in this matchup, all the decks with that counter spells, they usually have Stony Silence too, so I need to bring in something to answer that, like this erase. Yeah, I'm just gonna jam it. If I had a KCI in play, he could crack Relic in response, and then with the Open the Vault still in the stack, I could sacrifice some cantrips and still get value. Right now, I'm just trying to get rid of his Relic. Yeah. Very rare that Relic is actually good, but it was pretty all right here. And now it's at this stage of the game, whereas if I was playing the Urza-Tron lands instead of these artifact lands, I might have just been able to cast Emrakul normally with this many lands in play. Oh, I'm dead on board. How about that? Okay. I think I just have to click submit again. Yep. Oh, maybe Blood Moon's good in this matchup? I don't know.